We're back for another deep dive of the Deep Space Divorce Saga by John Oakley McElhenney.
This time, we're taking a look at a chapter excitingly titled, The Crew Must Survive.
Oh, yeah.
Which I think is really fitting when you think about where John and his family are at this point in the book.
Right. Still reeling from that metaphorical crash landing we talked about last
day. Yeah, exactly. Still stranded on the moon after the upheaval of divorce.
Trying to figure out how to generate enough fuel to make it back to Earth.
And in this chapter, that fuel, it becomes pretty clear that it's financial stability.
Mm-hmm. Which John is desperately searching for all summer long.
Yeah, he spends weeks and weeks looking for work with very little luck.
So you can really feel that tension building.
It's like he's stuck in this lunar rover with a sputtering engine.
You know that feeling, needing to get things back on track but feeling totally stalled.
Oh, absolutely. And I think that's what John is wrestling with here.
So when he finally lands this job at a tech company after all those interviews...
Oh, you can practically hear the sigh of relief.
It feels like that's problem solved.
Right. Like he's finally found the launch codes to get them back on course.
Back to Earth.
But then on his second day, bam.
He gets called into a meeting.
And abruptly fired.
It's brutal.
It is. And the way John describes the CEO.
This hipster looking dude with a flair for purple pocket squares.
Yeah, and he barely even looks at John during the whole meeting.
And the reason they give for firing him is almost laughable.
I know, right? They fire him for his writing on the Huffington Post.
His divorced dad writing.
Which they deem incompatible with their brand.
I mean, come on. Didn't they even Google him beforehand?
It's unbelievable, right?
Yeah.
You would think in this day and age, they would have done their due diligence.
Especially a company that prides itself on being culture first.
It makes you wonder about their definition of culture.
Right. What's fascinating, though, is how John reacts to this whole thing.
Initially, he's devastated, obviously.
Yeah.
But then he has this amazing shift in perspective.
He sees it as dodging a bullet.
Exactly. He realizes this company, with its lack of authenticity, wouldn't have been a good fit long term.
So instead of wallowing, he uses the experience as fuel.
I love that. And I think this is where the space travel metaphor really clicks, you know?
Like when you're in space and you have to use every bit of debris, even the bad stuff, to propel yourself forward.
That's exactly it. That's what John does here.
He turns this negative experience into a positive realization.
And a powerful one at that. He realizes his writing, his vulnerability about being a single parent is more important than any job.
He actually calls it his life's purpose.
It's like he's been circling Earth this whole time, and now he's finally got the coordinates for his mission.
He's locked in.
And you see that theme of resilience pop up again and again.
He doesn't just sit around feeling sorry for himself.
No, he immediately starts hustling for freelance work.
Making sure he can still provide for his kids.
Talk about resourcefulness.
Yeah.
He finds a way to make things work, even when it feels like the universe is throwing everything it can at him.
This is where I think we start to see the real John emerge.
Right.
You know that friend who can take any bad situation and somehow find a way to laugh about it?
Oh, yeah. I know the type.
That's him.
And that humor, it's so important.
It's what helps him stay afloat in the face of adversity.
Absolutely. Not that he's ignoring the hardships of divorce.
No, he's incredibly honest about the financial strain and the emotional toll it takes.
But he also chooses to find the good in the midst of it all.
Which isn't always easy.
Definitely not. And I think that's what makes his story so relatable.
He's not some superhero.
Right. He's just a guy.
Trying to do his best in a really tough situation.
And making us laugh along the way.
This whole experience with the tech company, it almost feels like a test.
You think so?
Yeah. Like, to see if he's really committed to this new path of writing.
And he passes with flying colors.
He does. Because instead of letting it derail him, he doubles down on his writing.
He realizes that his vulnerability, his willingness to share his story, is actually his strength.
Which is a pretty amazing takeaway, don't you think?
It really is. Especially in a world that often tells us to hide our flaws.
Right.
John's showing us the power of embracing them.
And that's something we could all learn from.
Absolutely.
I think that's a good place to pause for now. We've covered a lot of ground in this first part of the chapter.
Yeah, we have. From the desperation of the job search to the crushing blow of getting fired.
And then that incredible moment of self-discovery where John finds his purpose.
A real turning point in his journey.
It is. And it makes you wonder what's next for him.
I can't wait to find out.
Me too. We'll dive into the rest of The Crew Must Survive in our next segment, so stay tuned.
Don't go anywhere. So John, he finds his purpose, but it's not enough to just find it.
Right. He has to actually go after it.
Exactly. He doesn't just talk about wanting to write. He actually makes it happen.
Even if it means taking on all those freelance gigs.
And juggling multiple deadlines.
It's like he's a one-man mission control.
Trying to manage all these different projects.
While still being a present dad to his kids.
And it's that resilience again, right? Finding a way to make it work no matter what.
And he manages to do it all with a sense of humor.
Oh, always. Like that part where he compares the holiday season to a single-parent Super Bowl.
That's so John.
Right. He finds the absurdity in these everyday situations that I think a lot of parents can relate to.
It's a way of coping with the stress.
Exactly, like putting on your own oxygen mask first so you can help everyone else.
His humor is his oxygen mask.
It lets him be the best parent he can be.
And it's clear that his kids are his top priority.
Oh, absolutely. He's constantly talking about wanting to create a stable and loving environment for them.
Even in the aftermath of the divorce.
He wants them to know that even though their family looks different now, the love is still there.
Which is such a powerful message for kids of divorce.
Because so often they blame themselves or think their parents don't love them anymore.
John's story is a reminder that divorce doesn't mean the end of family.
It just means that the family is evolving.
And that evolution can be messy and painful at times.
For sure. But it can also lead to something beautiful and new.
Like John's relationship with his writing.
Something that wouldn't have happened if he hadn't gone through the divorce.
It's like it forced him to reevaluate his priorities.
And discover a part of himself he didn't even know was there.
And that discovery leads him to that amazing new job in December.
At a company that actually embraces his writing.
It's such a contrast to that first job where he was fired for being a single dad.
It really is. You can tell he's so much happier in this new environment.
They have lunch together every day.
I know. It says a lot about their company culture.
Right. They value him as a person.
Not just an employee.
And the fact that he feels comfortable enough to tell his new colleagues about that one-day job fiasco.
It shows how much trust he's built with them.
He's finally found a place where he can be himself.
Both personally and professionally.
Isn't that what we all want?
To be accepted for who we are, flaws and all.
And it's not just about finding a job, it's about finding a community.
A place where you feel supported and understood.
A place where you can launch your dreams.
Without fear of judgment.
And I think that's what John finds at this new company.
A launch pad for his next chapter.
Which brings us back to that space travel metaphor.
They've been through a lot.
They've weathered the storm.
They've used their setbacks as fuel.
They've navigated the uncharted territory of divorce.
And now they're finally preparing for liftoff.
But the question remains, will they actually reach their destination?
Will they find that sense of normalcy and happiness they're looking for?
That's the cliffhanger we're left with at the end of the chapter.
And it's a question I think we all grapple with, whether we've been through a divorce or not.
Because we're all on this journey called life, right?
With its twists and turns.
And its moments of uncertainty.
Like being stranded on the moon with a sputtering engine.
But John's story is a reminder that even in those dark moments, there's always hope.
There's always a chance to find our way back.
Back to a place of purpose and belonging.
We just have to be willing to embrace the journey with all its ups and downs.
And maybe even find a little humor along the way.
Because sometimes the most unexpected detours can lead us to exactly where we need to be. It really makes you think, right?
It does. And that's what makes the Deep Space Divorce Saga so powerful.
It's not just about divorce.
Right? It's about so much more.
Resilience, finding your purpose, the importance of family.
Those universal themes we all grapple with.
Whether we've been through a divorce or not.
And it's told with such honesty and humor.
You can't help but connect with John's journey.
He's not afraid to show his vulnerability.
His struggles, his doubts.
But he never loses sight of the bigger picture.
He knows that even though things are tough right now, there's still so much to be grateful for.
And that gratitude fuels him.
It helps him stay positive.
Even when things feel impossible.
It's like he's saying, hey, life threw me a curveball, but I'm not going to let it knock me down. I'm getting back up and I'm going to keep swinging.
That's a message we all need to hear sometimes.
Especially when we're facing our own challenges.
It's a reminder that we're not alone.
We all have our own deep space divorce sagas.
Our own moments of feeling lost and adrift.
But we have the power to choose how we respond.
We can let those challenges define us.
Or we can use them as fuel to propel us forward.
Like John did.
Exactly. We can embrace the journey even with all its twists and turns.
And find the beauty in those unexpected details.
Because sometimes the most difficult experiences are the ones that teach us the most valuable lessons.
And lead us to our true destination.
We're all on board with McKellany's Deep Space Divorce Saga, and we can't wait to take a deep dive into the next chapter, preparing to disembark, lift off from Tranquility Base.
See you. stay tuned and stay safe in your own little rocket ship of love.